You asked for it, so here it is. Now, I wasn't actually planning on making this video, but I got enough requests for it that I'll give you what you want. That's what we're here for, right? Another why pay twice as much video in the same week. The Sony a6400 has really set the new standard for me as the best online content creation camera currently on the market. It's got great looking image quality, crazy good autofocus, and a flip up screen for monitoring. The G85 is not in my hand though, because it's our B cam. It's my favorite B cam ever made. It is a couple of years old, but it's also got fantastic image quality all of its own with some amazing stabilization, a flip screen, and it just works so well. I mean, quick side note here, these are my two personal cameras for all the videos you've seen in the last couple of months. So this is going to be a tough video to make. The Sony a6400 versus the Panasonic Lumix G85. Is the a6400 worth twice the price? Let's find out. What's up everyone, I'm the Everyday Dad, and if I can figure it out, you can figure it out. Whew. This is going to be a tough one because I really, really like both of these cameras. They each have some crazy strong aspects that for their price points, they crush literally everything else on the market. I would argue in their respective class, neither of these cameras actually have any competition. Period. There just isn't anything competing against these two cameras. But that doesn't mean they can't be competed against, because that's definitely what we do here. So what makes these two cameras fantastic is going to be compared against four separate areas of video quality, ease of use, fiddliness, and ecosystem. None of that should be surprising, as that's what we normally do around these parts. But the rest of the video is going to be recorded on the a6400 and G85. Wow, that's kind of an unsurprising surprise, right? I mean, these are my two personal cameras, so this isn't like that big of a deal. It's just like the way, right? either way. First up, video quality. The Sony a6400 has a 24 megapixel APS-C sensor and can record in up to 4K 30 frames per second. The Lumix G85 has a 16 megapixel Micro Four Thirds sensor, but it can also record in up to 4K 30 frames per second. Mm-hmm. Now, if you don't know much about sensor sizes, basically the Sony has the bigger, higher resolution sensor. It does cost twice as much, but this gives you a few benefits and hindrances. It's not all sunshine and rainbows. First benefit is you have less of a crop. These are both crop cameras, by the way, if you didn't know, which is 1.5 times, whereas on the G85, the Micro Four Thirds, you get a 2x crop. So the lenses might be the same or roughly the same focal length, but will get displayed very differently. For example, the Sony is currently on a 24 millimeter lens and the G85 is on a 25 millimeter lens, but they look very different because the Sony is roughly 35 millimeters and the Panasonic is roughly 50 millimeters. So that crop does have a big difference. Science! For image quality though, both actually look pretty darn good. I think these are two of the strongest cameras out there for the price and actually getting fantastic looking video. Like you get so much value for money here. And I know I'm gonna catch a lot of load of anger for this and some flack in the comments, but I think both look so good that it's too close to say which is better. Either would serve really well when recording online video, and one of the very cool benefits about both of these cameras, which is rare, so it's surprising that we have two cameras at the same time that can do this, is neither camera has a recording limit. Let that sink in. These will record as long as you give them media and power. That's really impressive. Now, the two biggest differences when it comes to image quality is the a6400 has one of the best autofocusing systems I've ever used. Hands down, it's better than Canon, it's better than Fuji, it's better than Nikon, it's better than everyone. I mean, it's creepy good that it never leaves your face alone. I mean, just always, it's always got your face. It's like, it's creepily awesome. And the G85's autofocus is not as good. In fact, I never use it because while it's okay for acquiring focus, when set to continuous video autofocus, it has the Panasonic problem of being a contrast-based system. So it will have these like wobbles in the background that I can't take them anymore. So we just don't use it anymore. So while it tries to like maintain its plane of focus, and to do that, it has to hunt back and forth a little bit, which is super obvious. But it's not all gloom and doom for the G85 because the smaller sensor allows for some pretty fantastic in-body image stabilization, which the a6400 is totally lacking in any way, shape, or form. It doesn't even have Canon's electronic image stabilization. The G85 stabilization is one of the best features of the Panasonic Micro Four Thirds cameras. You don't really need much to get smooth footage out of it. And as shaky footage is like one of the worst things ever, it's awesome. I mean, yeah, it would do better with a gimbal, but for doing simple handheld shots like vlogging, it's amazing. But don't take my word for it, let's hop outside real quick for a video slash vlogging test.
Welcome to the vlogging test of the Panasonic G85 and the Sony A6400, two of my very absolute favorite cameras I've ever used. And these are two, like we said in the beginning of the video, these are my personal two cameras that I do everything on this channel with. I like both of them. The thing is though, I don't really think this is that fair of a video because I think the G85 is probably the best vlogging camera that you're gonna get at the price. Panasonic cameras have great stabilization, fantastic 4K video quality, and the audio preamps are pretty darn good too. The A6400 has some of the best autofocus, fantastic image quality, and it just, oh, it's so good too. And it's got an APS-C size sensor, but the stabilization and the flip out screen, look, the G85 has the flip out screen as opposed to the A6400's flip up screen, and it just, oh, it works so good. I hate pitting these two against each other because I love them so darn much, but I think the stabilization and the flip out screen on the G85 will easily trounce the A6400 when it comes to like an out and about camera that you're gonna hold. Now, if you're gonna set these things up fixed and you're just gonna do fixed video like I do a lot of the time, the A6400 is easily the best because that autofocus image quality is just, oh, it's beautiful. I love both of these. I don't wanna pit you guys against each other. I love both of you. They're currently both recording in 4K 24 frames per second. They both have their kit lenses on, which have optical stabilization, but the dual IS on the G85, even though my shoulders are now on fire, I can only hold these cameras for so much. But okay, this has been the vlogging test. I love both you guys. Don't break my heart like this. I don't wanna pick. I don't wanna pick anymore. Okay, back to the video.
And we're back. I mean, yeah, they both look fantastic, but in a vlogging scenario, I'd personally take the G85 because of the stabilization. I mean, you cannot beat it for what you pay for this camera. Something more important to me, however, is how easy is the camera to use? Because online content creators ain't got no time to be messing around with these tools. We've got to set up, get going, get usable footage, get back to edit, and then be done because you got the next videos lined up. Both cameras are very well built and very well weather sealed. The A6400 is more of a rangefinder style camera, where the G85 is a smaller, but more traditional DSLR style shaped camera. The Sony is rocking the new menu system, which is much improved over the older Sony models, but the big difference in this setting is the G85 has a fully touch enabled, fully articulating screen. I mean, that allows for movement through one of the best user interfaces around through touch, which is, that gets a big thumbs up for me, always. Fully articulating touchscreen, I'll give you a big thumbs up. Doesn't matter who you are. Much like GoPro, I really like this particular Panasonic menu system way more than I like even the new Sony system. I mean, it's very intuitively laid out, easy to customize with plenty of function buttons, and it's tap to focus and app support. We're using the app right now to record with the G85. I mean, it's the best on the market. This is my Pixel 3a that is basically turned into the G85 controller. Seriously, just like the Sony has the best autofocus, Panasonic has the best app. I mean, it's totally worth buying the camera for just that. Plus, if you're doing any kind of product B-roll, the 4K live cropping on the G85 makes your life so much easier. Heck, I always have to have at least one Panasonic camera in my kit just for that feature alone. I mean, the whole reason we have the G85 is for that feature. So this ease of use easily goes to the Lumix. But after you hit record, life gets real, and getting usable video as quickly as possible is the name of the game. Well, the name of the game is actually called fiddliness though. That's what we call it here. Here it's a little different because, as you well know, there are three things that I'm looking for to judge a camera to call it fiddly or not. That's good autofocus, some way to monitor it built into the camera, and stabilization. Like we mentioned earlier, the A6400 has the best autofocus in the game. Boom, done deal. Plus it's got a flip up screen that lets you monitor everything, but again, it's missing stabilization. So darn close to the perfect camera. I mean, it's that close. The G85 has terrible autofocus. Some of the worst in the game. Boom, second done deal. It's got that flip out screen that shows the exact same information as the Sony. And again, it's got great stabilization. So here there be decisions, because I can't tell you which camera wins this particular category because both do their separate things as best as a camera can. They both are best at what they do. There's a reason I own both of these cameras. This did not just randomly happen. So you've decided to get one of these fantastic little cameras, but what do their overall ecosystems look like? Well, the Sony has the ever popular E-mount, but as this is an APS-C camera, there aren't as many good lenses as I'd like. I mean, yes, you can use the full frame lenses, and yes, they do have the awesome Sigma Trinity and a few other really good ones, but they're missing some key native lenses and their zooms are nothing to write home about. I do really like the kit lens, the 16-50 kit lens. It's one of my favorite kit lenses of all time just because of how small it is, but it's not the best optically. I do wish they had more crop zoom options. The GD5 has access to a full range of lenses because there are two camera manufacturers in the Micro Four Thirds space. And I really like those lens lineups because it's got just about everything you could want, from zooms to primes to everything. You got it all. Plus, I mean, they are small and I like small lenses for these small bodies because that's one of the reasons I don't like the full frame lenses on the A6400. Takes it and makes it too big. But at the end of the day, is the A6400 worth twice the price of the G85? That's such a tough question. I mean, look, both are fantastic cameras and you would be perfectly well served with either. I mean, I think the A6400 is currently the best camera released in 2019 for the online creator. It's such a darn beast of a workhorse that you could easily run everything about a YouTube channel, Instagram account, TikTok, whatever, with just this one camera. But the GD5 looks great and is like $500 used. I mean, I got this with the kit lens for 500 bucks. I do actually think that the A6400 is worth twice the price though. I mean, you just never need to worry about your video being in focus and the auto exposure is on point. And that's, I mean, that's really what you need out of a camera, in focus and properly exposed video. And you never have to worry about that with the A6400. It's just darn good. Thanks for watching.